What is also disturbing the experts is the constantly mutating form of this virus, thought to have been created by an artificial intelligence.
I have a new addition to my collection of old LCD monitors. It is a ViewSonic ViewPanel VP150, and it's also my oldest. It was made in August 1999, so it is officially 11 years old. My other two are a NEC multi-sync LCD 1550M, which has built-in speakers, and a Philips 150S. This one I have running on my ThinkPad here. And pretty good image quality for its age. It has a noticeably warmer color temperature than the other two. I don't know if that's just because of the age or just the way they calibrated it. It does give you an adjustment for color, but no matter how I adjust it, it's always a little bit more reddish than the other two. And also has a nice menu system here. A lot easier to use than the one in the NEC monitor. All three of these are 1024 by 768 resolution, 15 inch. These two give you a built-in AC power supply, so you don't need an external brick like that one. And one thing I like is that all three of these give you a hardware on-off switch. So once you turn these off, it cuts off all power to the monitor. It doesn't just put them in sleep mode like modern LCD panels. Now these two give you a tilt swivel base. This one just gives you tilt. If you want to swivel it, you have to move the whole thing around. This one is also noticeably the heaviest and largest of them. You can tell the bezel is quite a bit thinner on this one. This one doesn't have a date on it, but I'm guessing around 2002-ish. Well, this is 1999. That's probably around 2000. I forgot to check for the date on that. You can see on the back it says August 1999. AC 100 to 240 volts, 1.2 amps. Made in Japan. Has this pop-off panel here for the connections. Just a regular AC power cord and VGA cable. It also says audio in, but if you look in there, it's just a knockout plug. So there must have been a fancier model with built-in speakers, which this one does not have. And it also gives you a thing for a Kensington lock. Due to its age, this one is also a little bit grainier than the other two, but it's still not bad. It's still overall a pretty good picture, especially for the price. These things are getting cheaper and cheaper now. They're not quite being thrown out just yet like CRT monitors, but these old LCDs are getting very inexpensive, so they make a good upgrade from a CRT if you're more concerned about size. Obviously CRTs still have some advantages in things like color reproduction and visibility angle from the side, but if you just want something small and built to last, these old LCDs make a good choice. And besides, they go well with older beige colored computers like this Compaq Despro EN, which I have the Lenovo logo on it just for comparison to the other two. So that's my collection of almost vintage LCD monitors, oldest one being from 1999, and it's still working fine. A lot of LCD monitors and TV sets from the 2000s seem to be dropping dead left and right due to bad capacitors. It's probably when they moved the production from Japan to China. Quality obviously was not maintained, so these older ones actually last longer. So thanks for watching.